Welcome to The Laboratory, a video series brought to you by Miracles Innovation Labs.
Hello all, I'm myself Pavani Moturi from Miracle Innovation Labs. This video is about Jasim, a healthcare appointment scheduling chatbot with a web channel. Coming to agenda, firstly, we will be discussing about introduction to healthcare chatbot, followed by overview of the bot, and then a quick demo of Jasim on a web channel. Also, we will be discussing about the technologies we use to build this chatbot. Finally, we will be discussing the architectural flow. Introduction to HealthBot Service. Microsoft HealthBot Service is a software as a service offering from Microsoft that is used to build and deploy health agents. Also, it is allowing the health organizations to provide intelligent conversational access to their users about health information. The main features of HealthBot Service are deliver intelligent conversational healthcare experiences and running the applications on a secured platform. Also, empowers the organizations to build and extend intelligent health assistance. Now let's discuss about the overview of the bot. By using this chatbot, we can able to book an appointment in the nearest hospital. Also, we can modify the appointment and check the status of the booked appointment. And finally, we can also cancel the booked appointment. Now I will be taking you through the live demo. So this is the website to which we integrated our chatbot Jasim. I'll start the demo by saying hello to the bot. It is responding like, "Hi, I'm Jasim, a healthcare chatbot. How can I help you today? What can you do?" It is responding like, "Hi, I'm Jasim. I can help you with appointment management services." So appointment management services are like scheduling an appointment, modifying or canceling an appointment, and as well checking the status of the appointment. So first I would like to schedule an appointment. So for scheduling an appointment, we need some specialized doctor, right? So here we have three specializations like cardiology, dermatology and neurology. So you can go with any of the specializations. And then if you have any gender preference to your doctor, like you want to specifically go with female doctor or male doctor, you can go. If you don't have any gender preference, you can directly go with no. Then like if you want to meet a doctor who is nearby your location, you can search for that doctor. Like you can enter zip code or state or city. So I want to meet a doctor who are nearby my location, 48374 zip code. So based on those details, I got list of doctors who are nearby me and as dermatology specialized, 48374 zip code. I got two doctors. I would like to schedule an appointment. So for scheduling, we need to give some basic details, right? I have to give my details as a patient. And then mail ID. And then date of birth. And then phone number. On which date would you like to see Dr. Anna Finicky? So on particular date we want to schedule our appointment, right? On May 21st at 8 o'clock due to some skin allergy. After giving the date of appointment, we need to give our insurance details. So my insurance provider name is Aetna, and this is a sample health card which you have generally for any health insurance. So from your card, you have to enter your group ID. So my group ID was, this is my group ID, and the member ID was like, this is my member ID. So this, you need to enter these insurance details for the first time. So next time onwards, if you are using this bot and you are scheduling an appointment, it won't ask for your details to re-enter again. It will show those details. If you are okay with those details, you can directly schedule an appointment. So with all my details, my appointment has been successfully scheduled with Dr. Ami Finicky on 21st May. This is a sample card which can show all your details like patient name, appointment, date and time, and the address of the hospital. Just now we scheduled an appointment, right? So let us check whether this has been created or not, like scheduled or not. For that we have option called check the appointment status. In order to check the appointment status, we need to give some details like which patient is going to check their status. For that we have to enter our details which we have given previously. And then date of birth. And then phone number. So we have created only one appointment, right? With Dr. Ami Finicky on 21st May at 8 o'clock. So our appointment has been successfully scheduled. From here, you can directly update your appointment if you want, or you can directly cancel your appointment from here onwards. Otherwise, if you don't want these two options, you can go with others. But now I would like to update my appointment. Sure. For which day are you looking for schedule this appointment with Dr. Ami Finicky? So this, I would like to reschedule this to 22nd, 8 o'clock. So our appointment has been successfully updated to 22nd, 2019 May. Okay. So again, I would like to schedule another appointment with the same doctor. Let us see what happens. So I would like to schedule an appointment with the same doctor. Like another patient comes and they want to schedule to the same doctor. Then let us see what happens. With the same doctor, Ami Finicky. And this time we can give another details, like another patient details. And mail ID. Date of birth. And then contact number. So every time we are scheduling an appointment and updating appointment, right? Every time we are getting the text messages and emails as well. So I would like to schedule this to the same doctor on the same date, May 22nd at 8 o'clock, right? Previously we scheduled our appointment due to skin allergy. See what happens? I see the time slots are busy on this particular date and time. Would you like to change this time? So I would like to schedule this to May 24th. So if the doctor is busy at that particular time and date, and so this bot can able to show them like the particular doctor is busy at this particular date and time. You can go with some other time. Now I would like to schedule this to 6 p.m. due to same reason. And this time my insurance provider name is Aetna, and we have to give our insurance provider details, member ID and group ID. So again, our appointment has been successfully scheduled with Dr. M. Finke on 24th May. Okay. Let us check again. Check the appointment status. First, Smith, like whether it has been scheduled with the right time and date or not. So, smith123@gmail.com. And the date of birth. And the phone number. See, it has been scheduled with Dr. Ami Finke on 24th March. So from here, we can cancel our appointment directly. Previously, we updated from the checking the status, right? We can cancel it here. Would you like to cancel it? If you cancel this, you may lose the slot. If you say yes, your appointment will be successfully canceled. So this is all the functionalities which we implemented. Here are the technologies used to build a bot. Firstly, Microsoft HealthBot Service is a software as a service offering that empowers healthcare organizations to build and deploy AI-powered health agents. Here, we used Microsoft Bot Service as a tool to build the scenarios. And then, Louis is a Microsoft Cognitive Service. We used Louis to train the intents and entities. And next, Microsoft Azure. Microsoft Azure is an open, flexible cloud computing platform. So we used Microsoft Azure to maintain our backend in a cloud environment. Next, Nexmo provides innovative communication, SMS and voice APIs. We used Nexmo for sending SMS to the patients after booking, modifying and canceling the appointments. And then Node.js. Node.js is an open source cross-platform JavaScript runtime environment that executes JS code outside the browser. Here we use Node.js as a middleware. And finally, MongoDB. MongoDB is a cross-platform document-oriented database classified as a NoSQL database. In this bot, we used MongoDB for storing the patient information. Now let us see the architectural flow of this bot. Initially, the user interacts with the bot in a web channel, and a message given by the user will be sent as an input to the Louis. And Louis analyzes the user input. Based on this intent, a specific scenario will be triggered. And from that scenario, we are going to hit the backend. From that backend, if you have any database calls, it will go to the MongoDB. And after scheduling the appointment and modifying the appointment, we are sending SMSs to the users using Nexmo service. And finally, we are scheduling all these bookings in a Office 365 Microsoft booking from the Microsoft. This is overall architectural flow of this bot. Thank you.
Thank you for watching The Laboratory, a video series brought to you by Miracles Innovation Labs. For more on innovation, please visit miraclesoft.com/innovation. the labs.